So are sciences really objective? Well, being human, it is impossible to be totally objective about anything, because we all have preconceptions about the world around us. The fact is, you cannot really be objective if you know anything about a topic, because knowledge on a topic creates opinions that influence preconceptions. So you can only be totally objective if you are totally ignorant. This is why juries are selected from people who know little or nothing about the case. In science, there are three main steps in dealing with data: collection, organization, and interpretation. Collecting of data includes both measuring and recording. It is the most objective part of science, partly because much of this is done by machines. In any case, this is where true scientific objectivity is found. Now, this process is not totally objective, partly because the selection of data to be tested is not always objective. In fact, it is often based on what the theory being used says to look for. However, this part of the process is still the most objective. The organizing of data includes the categorizing of data sets, and once an organizing system exists, it influences how data is seen. This causes a loss of objectivity. The interpretation of data heavily depends upon the theoretical system being used, because different theoretical systems produce different interpretations. And a flawed theoretical system causes flawed interpretations. The simple fact is that scientists using different theoretical systems on the same data can produce different and even contradicting interpretations.